Hi, in this video we're gonna cover the edit profile section that you can find when you click on this little arrow next to your avatar and then choose edit profile. Now in this edit profile section you can see a lot of information and also update the account information that you have. Number one, you see here the referrer ID, that's your personal referrer that you had and the name of the referrer. And you see as well your own ID and your affiliate ID that you chose when you signed up. Now, by the way, one side note already now, if you want to change your affiliate ID, you can do that also up here under Edit Affiliate ID. And if you need to update your password, you can do that here under Edit Password. All other site settings you can update under Edit Site Settings. Now let's continue with what you can edit on this page here. First, you see your affiliate link here, and as you can see, your affiliate ID is part of your affiliate link. And by changing affiliate ID, you can basically update the look of your affiliate link. Just make sure that you understand that if you change your affiliate link, that your old affiliate link will not work any longer. Next part here is the avatar, which will automatically be taken from your email address that you used to sign up for Infinity Traffic Boost. And it will take your avatar from gravatar.com. And if you like the default avatar shown here, simply click on this link, edit your Gravatar account or sign up for Gravatar account and upload your picture there. So your picture is shown properly right here, as well as up here and on other sections of the site. Now, the next field here is optional. That's the business name. Then you have the first name and last name. And by the way, the one asterisk and two asterisk fields are both required for you to enter if you are outside of Australia. And if you're inside of Australia, you also need to enter the details in the fields that have three asterisks. So let's continue. After the first and last name, you have here a field to update your account email address. And just note that if you change the email address, you need to reactivate your account. There will be a link that's sent to your new email address that you need to click on in order to activate your account again. The following fields are the address, the city, state, zip, and country. And by the way, the name and the address need to be accurate for taxation reasons. Then you have an optional field, the best phone number and the Skype ID. And these next two fields here that I see here are because I'm Australian, so I need to enter if I'm just here registered and my ABN number if I have one. By the way, if I don't have an ABN number, I can also provide a statement by a supplier, which I can get by clicking right here. Now, to be able to save all the details, you need to click here on email security pin, and a one-time pin will be emailed to you at this email address that you're registered with. Once you received it in your email, you simply enter your security pin right here and click on Save Profile. That's already all you need to know about the Edit Profile section. Thanks a lot for watching this video and have a great day.